The Republicans' expert witness last week, Professor Turley, wrote in an article that, quote, there is no question that the use of public office for personal gain is an impeachable offense, including the withholding of military aid in exchange for the investigation of a political opponent. You just have to prove it happened, close quote. That was Mr. Turley's comment. Now, Mr. Goldman, did the investigative committees conclude that the evidence proved that the president used his public office for personal gain?
Yes, Mr. Chairman.
And in fact, finding of fact 5 said President Trump used the power of the office of the president to apply increasing pressure on the president of Ukraine and the Ukrainian government to announce the politically motivated investigations desired by President Trump. And did the evidence also prove that President Trump withheld military aid in exchange for an announcement of an investigation of his political opponent?
Yes, it did.
In fact, finding of fact 5B said, quote, President Trump, acting through his agents and subordinates, conditioned release of the vital military assistance he had suspended to Ukraine on the President of Ukraine's public announcement of the investigations that President Trump sought. And did the evidence demonstrate that President Trump undermined the national security interests of the United States?
Yes, in several ways.
And finding of fact 6 said, in directing and orchestrating this scheme to advance his personal political interests, President Trump did not implement, promote, or advance U.S. anti-corruption policies. In fact, the president sought to pressure and induce the government of Ukraine to announce politically motivated investigations, lacking legitimate predication that the U.S. government otherwise discourages and opposes as a matter of policy in that country and around the world. In so doing, the president undermined U.S. policy supporting anti-corruption reform and the rule of law in Ukraine and undermined U.S. national security. And did the evidence also show that President Trump compromised the national security of the United States?
Yes.
In fact, finding of fact 7 said, by withholding vital military assistance and diplomatic support from a strategic foreign partner government engaged in an ongoing military conflict illegally instigated by Russia, President Trump compromised national security to advance his personal political interests. And did the evidence prove that President Trump engaged in a scheme to cover up his conduct and obstruct congressional investigators?
Yes, right from the outset.
And in fact, finding of fact 9 says, using the power of the office of the president and exercising his authority over the executive branch, President Trump ordered and implemented a campaign to conceal his conduct from the public and frustrate and obstruct the House of Representatives' impeachment inquiry. Finally, the constitutional scholars from our hearing last week testified that the president's conduct toward Ukraine and pattern of inviting foreign election interference was a continuing risk to our free and fair elections. Did the evidence prove that President Trump was a threat to our elections?
Yes, it did, Mr. Chairman.
And in fact, finding of fact 8 says, faced with the revelation of his actions, President Trump publicly and repeatedly persisted in urging foreign investments, foreign governments, including Ukraine and China, to investigate his political opponent. This continued solicitation of foreign interference in a U.S. election presents a clear and present danger that the president will continue to use the power of his office for his first political gain, for his personal political gain, close quote, I would add, in the next election. I now yield to my counsel, Mr. Burke, for additional questioning.